This morning in the kitchen, Discover Newport has brought back Chef Gerry Dupont from Edible Creations. We were singing because right now it's just the two of us in the kitchen. And we're making Texas-style stuffed French toast, right?
Yes, we are. This is one of our dishes on our Mother's Day buffet menu.
Yeah, so you're open for Mother's Day. So if anyone is out there watching and they haven't quite figured out their brunch plans.
Two seatings, 11 to 1 and 2 to 4.
Perfect. Sounds great, depending on what your schedule allows. So take us through the ingredients that we need. Whenever I hear Texas French toast, you got to have that thick bread, right?
Yep. Everything's bigger in Texas.
Including the bread. So what else do we need for this recipe in particular?
This recipe is actually not a recipe, because if you're making it for four people, you need less ingredients. If you're making it for 200, like we're going to be on Sunday, obviously you need more ingredients. But
we're somewhere in between 4 and 200 in the kitchen this morning. So.
The staples will stay the same. Eggs, milk, cinnamon and sugar mixed, obviously maple syrup for the finished product, cinnamon, bourbon vanilla I use in mostly everything I make.
Bourbon vanilla, is that something you can buy or something you have to make?
You can buy it.
Okay.
You can buy it. Yep, that's pure bourbon vanilla. Never use imitation. We actually use canned apples packed in water for this. They're more consistent than the regular apples. You don't have to cook them off. They're pre-cooked.
They're kind of ready to go.
And the cream cheese here we have in the bowl. The toast, and then we have some blueberries and strawberries and powdered sugar for later.
Yum.
And butter, of course.
Everything is better with butter, but I'm sure with the berries, too, kind of mix and match, whatever your preference.
Put whatever you like inside the French toast. We just happen to be doing the apple and cream cheese.
I like that combination, that apple and cinnamon together. All right, we've got all of our ingredients, and we're going to get things started in just a bit.
Now let's send it back into Will, who's in the kitchen with one of our favorites, Mr. Gerry from Edible Creations.
That's right. We are here in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, thanks to our friends at Discover Newport. Chef Gerry's here. Edible Creations is the place. We got Texas-style French toast on the menu. I love breakfast. I love breakfast. I love going to a great place where you can get some great French toast. That's what we're going to make here today.
And it's not stuffed with salmon.
And it's not stuffed with salmon. Attaboy, you get
Everybody
to come
Everybody knows
back.
Will hates salmon. Seafood.
All right, so what do you want to do right now? And what's in this bowl?
I put the cream cheese in already. Added a little bit of vanilla and a little bit of milk just to loosen it up a little bit. That's going to be our filling or our glue, so to speak.
Right.
After that's finished, we're going to put a little rim around it and then stuff the French toast and put
everything in it. Right. Now, I also noticed the bread that you have is very thick.
Yep.
That's what makes it Texas-style French toast.
Right.
I think French toast itself needs to have that to kind of like take it all flavor.
This particular brand actually, it's like sweetbread.
Oh, it is?
Like a Portuguese sweetbread.
I love Portuguese sweetbread, which is even better.
Right.
Oh, man.
And then the butter,
All right, so what do you want to do right now?
We're actually going to make our dipping liquid, which is eggs.
Just a couple of eggs in here.
A couple of eggs in there.
Crack this here. Hang on a second.
Put a little bit of vanilla.
Okay. And how many eggs do you want?
We could do all four.
All four? Okay.
I'm going to make some for everyone, so.
That's why you get to come back. That's why we have you back all the time. That's why we're
Feed people.
That's why
Feed people.
That's why we're bugging you. Put this here. Okay. All right, so we got four of the eggs in there.
Basically just whip that together.
I'm going to
mix this up a little bit, make it creamier.
And you can smell the cinnamon in here. You can smell the vanilla in here. It really has a great smell to it.
It'll give it
the
nice flavor. You can add more cinnamon if you like more cinnamon. You can take the cinnamon out of it totally if you don't like it.
And this is really what you're going to dip the thick cut bread in, right?
Right. After we stuff it.
With all the other goodness. Okay, sounds good. We are going to do this. We're going to make some good old-fashioned Texas-style French toast. Maybe you can make it for Mom this weekend. Back to you. Look at who's in the Rhode Show kitchen today. Chef Gerry is here. Edible Creations is just one of his, one of his gigs that he's got. Texas-style French toast is what we are making.
Mm-hmm. Montauk Country Club. Can't forget Montauk Country Club.
That's right, that's where you can get brunch this weekend.
This weekend, yes.
So
brunch
if you're looking for some place to go with Ma...
With Ma. Bring Ma. I don't even know what my mother's doing. What do you want to do, Ma?
Maybe she's going to brunch.
She'd be cooking. This is one of our items on the buffet this weekend.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And where, Gerry?
Montauk Country Club.
Oh, really? I had no idea.
Where is the country club?
It's actually in Portsmouth, Rhode Island, right off the highway. Can't miss it. We're there every day except Monday.
And you don't have to be a member of the country club to go and...
That's one of the biggest things that people can't get across to their head. They think country club, we can't go in.
Sure, but you can.
Nope, we welcome everyone.
Yeah.
All right, so take us through what you've done here to kind of sandwich this all together.
I have made the cream cheese filling with the vanilla and a little bit of milk to soften it up. This is going to be our glue. And put whatever fruit you'd like in it. I just happen to like apples.
Mm-hmm.
Cinnamon and sugar mixture on top.
A little sprinkle.
Great.
And then it actually makes
kind of glues it together.
Smush. From the outside, it looks like a fluff nutter. With that cream cheese filling coming out.
And then we just stick it in the batter.
Is that basic batter? Just some eggs, cinnamon, milk,
cinnamon, and vanilla.
Perfect.
Put that in a nice hot pan. You already put butter in the pan. Let that go.
Butter.
Some butter.
Now, you mentioned that the apples that you're using make this a little easier.
A lot easier, because they're canned apples, but they're processed already, par-cooked, packed in water, so there's no added sugar.
Mm-hmm.
It's in natural juices.
Great.
And it's just... I just think it tastes better, and it makes it a lot easier.
And that's nice, too, because you know when you bite into it, it's not that giant crunch of that apple.
Because if you processed your own apples at home, you'd have to... Well, I mean, you could. You could peel them and then parboil them.
Who wants
them
to just do another step? You know, make it easy on yourself.
These are great, too, because you can make up ahead of time, not put in the egg batter, but you can freeze them, Ziploc bags.
And then when you want to...
Pop them out at breakfast time.
Put them in and you're good to go.
Yep.
Nice. Bread. Especially if you got a large group coming over.
Yep.
And you said this bread is almost like a Portuguese sweet bread, so it has a little sweetness to it already, right?
Yep. Which it has a little sweetness to it.
Makes it even better. Makes it even better.
So about how long will those go on each side? Just enough to get them golden brown?
A little golden brown. Let's see. Let's flip this one over.
Give it a check. Maybe a little bit more.
A little longer.
All right, so what's going on at the country club that you're hanging out at?
What isn't going on at the country club?
Yeah, you've been busy.
It's crazy. It's a great crazy.
Mm-hmm.
We're open Tuesday through Sunday, 8 to 8, basically. You can come and have private events. We have a nice private room in the front. I call it the front. They call it the back.
Right.
it holds up to about 25 people comfortably.
Right.
The main dining room holds up to about 130. Comfortably full bar. Excellent drinks. Ray's there now.
Yeah?
Get on in and have
and
a cocktail.
And are your pastries there? Because every
time... We have a pastry case there.
Oh, that's
okay.
Inside. They all hate me because their waistlines are growing. And I just said, hey, get out there and swing some more balls.
Sure, yeah, there you go.
Yeah. So they're coming in from the golf course. They're getting you the pastries, taking them home, and everybody's happy.
And it's sunny this week, so it should be really, really busy.
That's good. That's good.
Do you still have another location of just Edible Creations,
We closed the Westport store, but we're still open in Little Compton. We will never go away from Little Compton. That's our home.
Right.
So,
and you can still go in there and get all your sweet treats.
Yep.
And
two chances to get
pastries
and stuff.
That's good. That's good. All right.
Yum.
So we're just going to sit here for just a little bit.
And I like the idea of stuffed French toast because you do regular French toast a lot, but
that's
for brunch, you want something a little
more
heartier.
Substantial.
Yeah.
This brunch we're doing this weekend, we have seafood Newburgh, we have carved ham, we have an omelet station, we have the stuffed French toast, bacon, home fries.
So if someone wants to take mom out, call for reservations now.
Call for reservations, definitely, this week. We got about, the first seating is almost full, second seating is about half full, so.
And remind about those times of the first
11 to 1 is the first seating, and then the second seating, we just need an hour to break down and then revamp, make it beautiful for everyone coming in at 2 o'clock.
Right.
Especially with that much variety.
Yeah.
You got to make sure there's enough for
that
second
group. Well, the whole linens need to be changed and we got the floral arrangements.
Start fresh.
Yep.
All right.
Sounds
2
like
to
a
4.
Lot of fun.
Looks good to me.
All right. We are going to start pulling those off and then, covering them
with
berries and confection sugar.
We
And then eat. If you want this recipe, head on over to roadshow.com.